What's going on, guys? If you have a new lawn or you did some overseeding this fall, you're gonna wanna keep watching this video so I can explain to you how to avoid destroying all that hard work you did by cutting it with a rotary mower. In this video, I'm going to do a quick review of the Greenworks 20-inch reel mower and also explain to you why, in my opinion, this is the only way to mow a new lawn. And hey, if you like my video content, don't hesitate to hit that subscribe button. So last year I did a complete lawn renovation of my entire yard, and I needed to find a way to mow my new grass without tearing everything up. So I did some research online, and at the time I didn't realize that reel mowers like this were actually still pretty popular, and there was a lot of companies still making them. I picked this up on Amazon for about $120, and I'm going to explain to you all the great features it has. Like most mowers, it does come with a rear bag, so you do have the option of either mulching your clippings or installing the rear bag to collect all your clippings. Installing the bag is pretty simple. It just has a couple of hooks and a clip, so it just takes a couple of seconds if you want to empty all your clippings. So this mower has about 9 different height settings. I think they're about every half inch. From what I remember, it goes down to about 2.5 inches to an inch or an inch and a quarter. Pretty nice if you want to mow really low. It's not going to be for you guys that want to get really low down to that half inch or 3/4 inch level, but still good enough to get it down pretty short or keep the lawn pretty long for that warmer weather. This mower is actually pretty lightweight. You can pick it up with one hand, which is actually a pretty important feature for using this to mow new grass or some overseeding that you did. Another great thing about reel mowers like this is the cutting action on this is like a shear cutting action, which is a very clean cut. That's important for stimulating or promoting new growth, which is another reason why I think it's great for new grass or overseeding, because what you're trying to do is cut this grass often, nice and clean, and promote more growth. So a few things that I didn't really like about this mower, or that I could see changing in the near future if somebody wanted to make some improvements. The bag is a little bit small, and when you're mowing grass and you're bagging, unless you're going, you know, at really fast walk pace, the grass blades themselves don't really kick all the way back to the bag. They tend to stay towards the front, so it doesn't hold a lot of grass. So I mean, if you've got a big lawn, you're going to be emptying this thing quite often. But in general, it does still work pretty good. So another thing about the reel mowers that I wasn't really aware of, because it was my first time ever owning one, was the amount of overlap that you actually have to do while mowing a lawn with your wheels. As you can see here, the blades are about 3-4 inches in from the edge. So you can't just mow wheel to wheel like you do with a regular riding mower or push mower. You've got to overlap your wheels about, you know, 4 or 5 inches in order to make sure you cut all the grass without leaving strips. The front wheels are about 10 inches in diameter and also have a rubber coating to them so that this thing performs like any other mower that you would use on your grass. It also features some adjustments to the blade height in the rear with a couple of nuts that you just kind of work with some springs. This is so that you can assure that you get a level, smooth, even cut. Mine came right from the factory, pretty well set. As far as assembly goes, basically it's pretty much pre-assembled. The only thing I had to do was install the handlebars, which only took a few minutes with a couple of wing nuts. And it actually comes apart pretty easy too for storage if you need to collapse it up really small. So the biggest reason for needing a reel mower on new grass is a rotary mower can create a lot of suction. And that suction can actually pull up new grass seedlings that aren't deeply rooted. and they can also suck up any of the seeds themselves that haven't fully germinated. And of course, the other big reason why I got a mower like this versus using my push mowers is the weight. When you're growing new grass or doing overseeding, you're watering a lot. So the ground can be soft and mushy, and you can end up leaving ruts with some of those heavier weight mowers. These things are pretty light. They're not gonna leave any major wheel tracks in your grass or in your soil. And they're not gonna damage the grass and tear things up like a regular mower would. So it's the weight of something like this that makes it very convenient for mowing a new grass. So overall, this is actually a really great reel mower. And you don't have to have new grass in order to get something like this. It's actually great for people that have maybe a smaller yard and they don't want to deal with gasoline engines. I actually like using a mower like this in the cooler fall weather because my lawn seems to recover and grow a little faster when I cut it with something like this. So if you did manage to get down some seed this fall on a new lawn or some overseeding, you might want to consider getting a reel mower just like this so that you don't mess up all that work you did with a heavy rotary mower. Thanks for watching, guys. Feel free to leave some comments, and if you haven't already, click that subscribe button.